Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over arithmetic sequences. We're going to be learning how to find the common difference, nth term, explicit, and recursive formulas. All right, so let's write down the instructions for the example. It's as follows. For the given two terms of an arithmetic sequence. So we're dealing with arithmetic sequences here, of an arithmetic sequence. We are to find the following. A, find the common difference. B, we have to find the 51st term. Find the 51st term. And then we're to find the explicit formula. Explicit formula. And we're not just going to find the explicit formula, we're going to use it to verify the result we got in part B, okay? And verify your result in part B, okay? And then part D, we're to find the recursive formula. We have the explicit formula in part C. In part D, we're going to find the recursive formula. And then lastly, we're to find the first four terms of the sequence. All right, so the two terms that are provided for the arithmetic sequence under consideration are A14, which is equal to -116, and A30th, which is equal to -260. All right, so let's go ahead and answer these questions. Part A, we want to find a common difference. Now, when we're working with arithmetic sequences, there's only one formula that we have to work with, which is a formula, the nth term formula, an equals a1, the first term, plus n minus 1 times the common difference d. So these two terms give us some valuable information that can enable us to set up some equations. So first one, a14, what does that mean? It means that this is the 14th term. So for a14, n is equal to 14. Okay, now if n is equal to 14, then we can substitute the value of a 14 and n into this equation right here. So since if n is equal to 14, it follows that an at -116 is equal to a1. We do not know what the first term is, a1, plus n, which is 14, minus 1 times the common difference d. All right, let's look at what we just did again. In this case, when n is equal to 14, an is going to be -116. a1 stays the same, n is 14, minus 1d. All right, if we simplify this, this becomes, and when we switch it around, a1 plus 14 minus 1 is 13. 13d equals -116. Now, how about this term here? N is equal to 30. Can you generate a formula, an equation using this formula by applying n is equal to 30 and a30 is equal to -60 to this formula right here? If we do so just like we did for n equals 14, we have -260 equals a1, the first term, plus n, in this case, is 30, minus 1 times the common difference d. All right, so let's simplify this. If we switch it around, we have a1 plus 30 minus 1 is 29. D equals the 30th term, which is negative 260. All right, now what do we have here? This is a system of equations, a system of linear equations, and we can solve this by elimination or substitution. Now let's solve this by elimination. We can eliminate either the A1s and solve for D, or eliminate the D's and solve for A1. Which one is easier to accomplish here? Since it's easier to get the A1s to be opposites of each other, we can eliminate that one. So let's eliminate A1, okay? To do that, I'll just multiply the second equation by negative 1, which makes this the opposite of that, so when we combine, we can eliminate A1, all right? So if we do that, we have the first equation remaining unchanged, A1 plus 13D equals negative 116. And then the second equation becomes negative A1 minus 29D equals 260. All right, let's go ahead and add downwards. If we add downwards, we'll get negative 16D equals 144. To get D isolated, we'll divide both sides by negative 16. And we are our final result to be D equals negative 9. Okay? All right, now we have the answer for part A. The common difference is negative 9. But let's go ahead and find A1 while we're at it so that we can use it to answer the other questions, all right? So to find A1, we're just simply going to substitute the value of D into one of these two equations to solve for A1, okay? So let's use the first one. So we're gonna go A1 plus 13 times D. We already know what D is, right? D is negative 9. How do we know that D is negative 9? Well, that's the answer we just got here. Okay, so equals negative 116. Let's solve that. We have A1 plus negative 9 times 13 is negative 117. Change the sign right here. So we have A1 equals negative 117 equals negative 116. And then we get A1 by itself by adding 117 to both sides. You have A1 equals positive 1. All right. So our common difference, what is our common difference? Our common difference D is negative 9. All right. So that basically means that every time we're going to subtract 9 to generate terms of our sequence. Let's look at the B part. The B part, we're to find the 51st term. To find A51. This means find the 51st term. So what formula are we going to use? Well, the same Nth term formula. An equals A1 plus N minus 1 times D. A1 is 1. That's the answer we got in part A. N is the index of the term we're looking for, which is 51. And then our common difference D is negative 9. An is equal to A51. And that's what we're looking for. Okay, so let's compute what the value of A51 is using all this piece of information that we've assembled. So we're going to have A51 is equal to A1, which is 1, plus N, 51, minus 1, times the common difference, which is negative 9. All right, let's go ahead and simplify this. We're going to have 1 plus 50 times negative 9. Using our order of operations, we are going to have 1 minus 450, which is equal to negative 449. Let's try that again. Negative 449. All right, so that's what our 51st term is. negative 4 of 49. All right, let's move on to the next part. We are to find the explicit formula and then verify that our result in part B is in fact correct. So for the explicit formula, we're going to use the same formula that we use. Actually, we have only one choice, this AN formula. All right, to find the explicit formula, N is going to be equal to M. All right, that's the difference. N is equal to N, A1 is always going to be 1, and our common difference is always going to be negative 9. So these are the pieces of information we're going to put together to generate our explicit formula for the nth term of our arithmetic sequence with the given terms, okay? So substituting, we're going to have AN is equal to A1, which is 1, plus N, which is still N, minus 1 times the common difference, which is negative 9. All right? So we'll just go ahead and simplify this formula. We're going to have AN is equal to 1. Now we're going to distribute this negative 9 to these two terms in the parentheses. So we have negative 9n plus 9. Simplifying further, we have an equals negative 9n plus 10. All right, so this is our explicit formula. Explicit formula. Now, is it correct? What we're going to do is we're going to verify the accuracy of this result by determining, by finding the 51st term using this formula and then see if we have the same answer as part B. Okay, so verification, we're going to test it, okay, with n equals 51. Are we going to get negative 449? That's the question. So we're testing our result in part C. A51 is equal to negative 9 times 51 plus 10. Okay? So when we multiply this, we are going to have negative 459 plus 10, which equals negative 449. That's perfect. It checks out because that's what we had here. Okay, so our explicit formula is correct. All right, let's move on to the D part. We're to find the recursive formula. Recursive formula. Well, recursive formula is pretty straightforward to come up with. An equals, now we ask ourselves, in this sequence, what do you do to generate subsequent terms? You subtract 9 every time. Okay, so from the term before, you subtract 9 to get the next term. So if an is the next term, what do you do to the term before that? So if we want to write this as a list, you have an, right? What is the term before an in the sequence? The term before an in the sequence is an minus 1. Okay, so what do you do to the term before to get the next term? What do you do to an to get to an? What do you do to an minus 1 to get to an? You subtract 9. That's how the pattern is. You subtract 9 every time. So using the recursive definition, all we just simply write is the next term an can be found by taking the term before it and doing what? Subtracting 9. Simple and short. That's what the recursive definition is. Lastly, we are to find the first four terms of the sequence, first four terms. So let's go ahead and find that, the first four terms. We have the first term is 1, the second term A2. Remember what the recursive definition is, you always subtract 1, right? So the term before, I'm sorry, you always subtract 9. So the term before A1 minus 9 gives us negative 8. Let's find the next two. A3 is going to be the term before minus 9 again, which is negative 17. And then the fourth term is going to be the term before, minus 9, which is negative 26. All right, so our first four terms are first four terms are 1, negative 8, negative 17, and negative 26. All right, so that's that. But thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool clips such as this. And do post a comment to let us know what you think about this presentation. And do give us a thumbs up if you liked it. Feel free to share with your friends. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.